السلام عليكم جميعا. I believe you all can see me and you can hear my voice clearly. Yeah? Okay. So, السلام عليكم جميعا. And I'd like to welcome you to this presentation. Thanks to Oman Arab Bank for making this initiative. And I am part of Kafa'a, which is a company. I'm not actually an employee of Kafa'a, rather I'm an associate of Kafa'a. Now, I've been told that you are all, mashallah, young graduates who either have just graduated or have graduated over the past 3 years, So therefore, wish you all the best, inshallah. And we're looking forward for you to become our future leaders in this country, whether being a team leaders, a managers, general managers, or inshallah CEOs. I still remember some of my staff which I used to manage when I was back in PDO, and they have some senior positions in some of the companies in Oman, and they still call me Mudir, or they tell me that Ustad Mahmoud can Mudir Mali, or still some of them call me Mudir. Really feel proud for that one, and I'm wishing you all the best inshallah in your future, so to be leaders inshallah in the next 5, 10, 15 years. Okay, so what I'm going to be, before I talk about my presentation, which is project management, let me talk about myself. My name is Mahmoud Al-Lawati. I have retired 2.5 years back. I worked for PDO for almost 29 years. I graduated from UK in 1992 as an IT engineer, and I've worked in PDO for 12 years in the IT department. And they told me after that, no, Mahmoud, you're not good enough in terms of IT. You need to go into kind of more of commercial. So I've moved to contracting and procurement service. And my specialization is on the contracting, and specifically in terms of capital projects. So I don't know if you heard about مشاريع مثل هرويل 2AB, رباب هرويل. Yes, no, the oil and gas. These are some of the projects which I did throughout my career. In the last 3 years before I retired, تقريبا من 2018 صارت عندنا طبعا المشاكل المالية. فوزارة المالية, they brought a consultant to start looking at what are the problems that we're facing as a country. And Ministry of Finance have asked for support from PDO, and PDO has offered me to Ministry of Finance, and I worked with one of the ex-minister, the British government ex-ministers, is Lord Francis Moody, and upon which we did a work for 2 years. That the result of that work was the establishment of the Tawazun, سمعت عن التوازن initiative, which is actually built the whole of the 2040 vision was built on it. وكل الحلول اللي الحين قاعد تحطها الحكومة to overcome the financial crisis that we're going through. To resolve it, Now, I'm going to be switching between Arabic and English. Hope there is no problem with that. Yeah? Okay? All right. So, what I'm going to be talking about is project management. And that is where my expertise is. As I told you, I worked for almost 17 years in the contract and procurement section, primarily in terms of the capital project, and that's where my expertise is going to be happening. And what I'm going to be talking about is, I'm going to be talking to you about the phases of the different project management. And I'm going to talk about what do you mean by project, and how it's going to relate to you, And if you can see, project tibda min bidayat mushkila ila nihayatha. But I'm not going to be focusing on the whole of it, and I will focus on what I call the front-end loading, اللي هو حدد شنو المشكلة and how I'm going to be executing it. The execution part will come to it, just because you just set the plan, you just go and execute it, but on that kind of perspective. Now, any project, you initiate a project, you plan it, you execute it, and close it. And that's what I'm telling you. I'm going to be focusing on the initiation and on the planning aspect of things in it. I'll try as much as possible to give you some kind of experiences that I went through that hopefully that will help you in understanding and whatever. But if there is any issue, anything which is not clear, please stop me. in that perspective. I would like you to make it as much as possible an interactive kind of things for us, not for me to deliver something to you that you don't understand, whatever. Let's make it as interactive as possible. We always basically, there is, and it's known, when I say I have a problem, I tell you something, you might understand it one way. Another person might understand it a different way. Yeah. So the key thing for you is that when somebody tells you there is a problem, understand what is the problem. So many times we have done it is that I am saying to my staff, move in this direction, they are moving in that kind of a direction. I use the same word, but they interpret it differently. The first thing, guys, ladies and gentlemen, ask, if you don't understand, ask the question. There is no harm. So many times we sit in a meeting, somebody is talking, and I bet you نص الناس ما فاهمين وش يقول هذاك الشخص هذا لا بس كل واحد ساكت لأنه مستحي إحنا نتكلم إحنا هذا بيقولون ما فهم هذا no please whoever is ask the question is actually believe me he's helping all the others in that kind of a perspective so please you have to be crystal clear in terms of what is the problem or what is the you're working right now or you're going to be working right now when your boss is coming do this kind of stuff into it. If you have the slightest of a doubt please ask him because that's going to save a lot of time for you in terms of moving forward and solving the problem in a very quick and very accurate way kind of it. And you can see the customer wants something like this but look at the interpretation of the different people if you don't understand please ask That is going to serve you and help you in it. In any project, there are five stages that I'm going to be talking about. First one is challenge definition, current situation analysis, benchmarking, proposed solutions and options, and initiation, and that is the implementation side of things. Yeah? Kind of it. But what do you mean by a project? What is the project? انتوا كلكم ان شاء الله الحين بتصيرون managers و team leaders وهذه الاشياء كان of it, yeah? انا دائما كنت لما اشتغل اليوم اللي لما اجي الصباح الدوام اقول اذا لو انا اليوم ما جيت and if business runs normally is there a need for me as a manager? Business is running. Yeah, because we have processes, procedure, everything is running. So what is the responsibility of leaders, of managers, of whatever? Is to identify if there is a problem. And let's fix the problem. Or let's identify if there is an opportunity and let's grab on it. Yeah? Opportunity. الحين الحمد لله أنا متقاعد وحصل راتبي وهذا وأنا وزوجتي جالسين. فجأة قالوا تعال في أسهم Yeah? So what, do I keep quiet? Whatever you call it, السعر 126 بيسة, you all know it, yeah? واحتمال ما بين 150 ل 160 بيسة راح تنباع. Wow. Opportunity, صح? أنا ما عندي مشكلة. Everything is fine. But there is an opportunity to make a little bit of cash. That's an opportunity. Yeah? أو نشتغل في شركة أو أنا وزوجتي جالسين وهذا. شوف قبل شهرين مصاريفنا كانت افتراضا 500 ريال. الشهر اللي قبله صارت 550 هذا الشهر صارت 600 there is a problem yeah it's hurting my pocket yeah so I need to take an action against it yeah so either it's an opportunity now a problem might be a problem right now or it might be a problem which is going to be happening in the future طبعا انتم كلكم اصغر من تذكرون تذكرون اول مره سمعتوا عن اول مره لما نسوي الاحصاء عندنا في عمان أيام السلطان السابق الله يرحمه، yeah. الإحصاء شنو طلعت؟ What's everything الحمد لله everything نص شعب عمان شباب الحمد لله everything's okay hey wait a minute نص شباب عمان شباب الحين in 10 years time what is gonna be شنو بيحتاجون عمل والعمل is not like a switch I go and switch it on and off أجيب شركات وinvestment وهذا والمشكلة الحين عندنا الـ unemployment. So a problem might be right now, which is hurting me, مثل الشركة, I'm losing money. My profit is going down. My sales is going down. Yeah? Oh, right now, I'm seeing that there is a new product, شركات ثانية جايبة فلنفرض, which if I do not take an action right now, خلال سنة, guess what going to be happening to my profit? It's going to go down because that is the thing. So for me to capitalize on it, however, there is an opportunity to move forward. Clear? So that is what is a problem and what is an opportunity. And both of them, you can tackle them the same way. شيء واحد أقول لكم من خبرتي أيضاً, أنتوا بعدكم شباب, هذا بعد 5 سنوات, بعد 10 سنوات بتشتغلون, يصير عندكم خبرة, يجي عندكم موظف واحد, والله عندنا هذه المشكلة, إيه أنا عارف إن هذا سوي كذاك. Don't jump the gun. ياخذ بالعربي نسميها داخذن العزة بالنفس, صح؟ لا تيجي تخبرني منه أنا صار لي 10 سنوات أشتغل, تيجي تخبرني أنا الحين هذا شنو هذا. Don't do that. Be methodical in terms of your way of doing things. عندك مشكلة, حلل المشكلة, والخطوات هذه هي تحليل المشكلة. نعم. سوري.
الحين ما في تحليل مشكلة. السلام على المدير مباشر قال لك أوكي أنا
كذي. That is and that is wrong. سمعت عن مشروع سوري أنا بتكلم عن من خبرتي أنا, هذا يمكن بعض أنتم شباب هذا سمعنا عن مشروع اسمه كوثر. حق الكوثر في بيديو $50 million كلفنا. We did it, everything, and it's, we switched it on. The pipette and كل شيء مفروض مشي معاني لمدة 10 years. After 2 months, the pipette كلها راحت corroded. 10 سنوات it had a lifetime. In 2 months it went. Why? Why? Because the oil which was coming from the ground used to come a gas with it, such a high level of H2S, ثاني أكسيد الكبريت, yeah, that was مثل burning the pipes. That is front-end loading. بداية المشكلة ما فهمنا, ما حصلنا subsurface data. شنو اللي قاعد يطلع؟ حسبنا شيء والحقيقة شيء ثاني. We had to stop the project. We had to spend another $10 to $20 million to replace the pipelines kind of it and to make a treatment for the gas. Then we were able to have it. Yeah, typical thing. كل واحد يقول أنا عندي خبرة, لا تقول لي هذا هذا. But my advice to you, be methodical. مهما كانت خبرتكم. جاك ويلش سامعين عنه؟ يسمونه the manager of the century. جاك ويلش هذا خذا صار CEO مال GE General Electric وكانت is in debt. حولها إلى أكبر وأعظم شركة في العالم هذاك الوقت. قالوا لي كيف سويت؟ قال I didn't do anything. I used to call people, come and sit and talk. أنا أتكلم معاك, أنت تتكلم مع هذا, بتعطي آراء وهذا, that's it. And for me it's just to push them. A manager is not to tell you to go and do this whatever. It's on the contrary. It's to get maximum out of you. يقولون دائما لما تجلس في الميتينجز المانجر اقل واحد مفروض يتكلم, بس هو مفروض يخلي باله انه كل واحد منكم مفروض يتكلم. باغي اسمع رايك, باغي اسمع رايك, باغي اسمع رايك انت. الليدر is the person who can take all of us and move us from point A to point B in a way that we all move. ما في حد left behind, ما في حد left anything. That's a leader. So my first intake from this, guys, whatever experienced people you become, use your experience, whatever, don't force it. Be methodical. مرة ثانية, I'll take an example, another one. بداية سنة 2000, بداية 2000, British Airways كان عندهم مشاكل في الميلز which they were serving. They wanted to reduce the cost. So if I tell you they had a problem with the meals, which would you do? شنو الأفكار اللي بتعطوني إياها؟ غير الوجبة. Sorry. And do the موردين أرخص. They did not. Sorry. The cost. طيب. They went through this normal process. Guess what? زيتونة واحدة فقط نقصوا من الوجبة. 4.7 million pounds reduction. On what basis I do this, do that kind of it? You need to understand what is the problem. Don't jump the gun. And that's my second point to you guys. Don't jump the gun. be again methodical. اعرفوا شنو المشكلة، شنو أسباب المشكلة، بعدين بتعرفون الحل. عرفوا هنا إن الناس يمكن ما يحبون هذا. Just one olive من كل وجبة 4.7 million pounds. So, in any project, what we need is to go through the normal steps for you to understand the problem, understand what are the solutions, and deliver the project in a successful way. I will talk about this in general, but I will go to them into the detail. The first one is define what is the problem. إذا عندكم مشكلة, خلوا المشكلة very clearly. Don't say this and that kind of a problem. عندي مشكلة في البروفيت, I have a problem in my profit. عندي مشكلة في السيلز, I have a problem in my sales. As simple as that. في opportunity, I have OQGN. Don't go anything. واجد من الناس, they jump into solutions. Don't do that. مثال, أكيد كل واحد جايب سيارته وشفتوا الازدحام العامرات هذا, لا؟ فلنفرض أن أقول لكم عطوا, خلنحل المشكلة. المشكلة شنو هو؟ Congestion on Muscat Roads. Is it a good problem? Yeah? Congestion on Muscat Roads. Is it a good problem? Yeah? Muscat Roads? أي واحد؟ طريق الباطنة؟ طريق السريع؟ دارسيت؟ مطرح؟ Be specific. هل كل الأماكن فيها ازدحام ولا لا؟ ولا بعضهم؟ Be specific. رقم اثنين. Is it all the time? ولا only افتراضاً during peak hours اللي هو من الساعة 6 للساعة 9 ومن الساعة 3 أو 2 للساعة 5. You can see. So if you say that reducing congestion on Muscat Roads is very big. لكن congestion, reducing congestion on طريق مسقط السريع during peak hours, you can see you're shrinking it exactly, and here you will be able to focus what are the problem and focus what is the root causes of that problem. انت كل ما توسع المشكلة ما بتعرف. Try to narrow it down. مثل شركة عندنا, they're not making profit. فلنفرض بنك عمان العربي لا سمح الله, they're not making profit. Okay, decline in profit, other problem. اي profit بنك عمان العربي عندهم, يعطون loans, عندهم investment, عندهم so many things. Are they declining in all of them? Or no? Focus on which one do you want. So the key things, first of all, is that, guys, focus on what is the problem. Exactly. Yeah? كل ما وسعت المشكلة, كل ما تكون الحل ماله أصعب. حاولوا هذا. Now I know you're going to say that إذا شوارع عمان بتحلونها, إيه بس ممكن هذا. ممكن نفس الشيء ينطبق على افتراض الطريق الباطنة, يمكن أن ينطبق على طريق ظفار وهذا. Fine, okay, fix this and then we can find the other one. It might be that the solution you'll find here is applicable there. So it's just going to be what we call it portability. أني أنا أخذ الحل وروح أطبقه هناك. لكن إذا أنت تفتحه على مصراعي, it becomes really difficult for you. So try as much as possible. Understand what is the problem. Focusing the problem into as I want to say at very narrow, as narrow as possible, if you can, or be specific in it. The second thing is that when you're saying define the problem, that شنو حجم المشكلة؟ الحين مرجع مرة ثانية إلى congestion. تروح حق وزارة حق بلدية مسقط أو وزارة تقنية المعلومات أو المواصلات, يقول والله عندنا مشكلة في الترافيك واجد هذا. يقول so what? What does it mean? عندي مشكلة. Exactly. So now translate it into figure. كيف, how do you do it? I need you to tell me how much is costing me as a بلد كعمان. إذا أنا وزير, how much does it cost me? Now, how do I translate this thing? كم ساعة؟ فلنفرض الصباح من الساعة 6 للساعة 9 traffic, صح؟ Okay. كم سيارة تتأخر؟ كم سيارة تمسك في الترافيك؟ Let's take an example. 2000 سيارة. السيارة الوحدة كم تقريبا تتأخر؟ نص ساعة؟ 45 دقيقة؟ Fine. السيارة خلينا نقول على 1.8 liters. 45 دقيقة, we can calculate how much petrol does it consume extra, اللي هو منه انت اللي قاعد تدفعه, صح؟ هذا رقم واحد. رقم اثنين, انت بتتاخر كم؟ نص ساعه الى 45 دقيقه. انا عارف راتبك كم؟ 45 دقيقه. How much does it cost? I add that one. Yeah. طيب انت واصل 45 دقيقه متاخر، واصل طبعا مزاجك متعكر، شايل 1000 واحد وهذا، واللي داق لك هرن، واللي ما اعرف ايش هذا. It will take you another half an hour to cool down. يمكن هذا. This is the way you calculate. When you're talking about a bank is losing profit, how much? You need to quantify. لأنك أنت لما تروح عند مديرك تقول له أنا عندي مشكلة، هذه المشكلة وهذه المشكلة. You define the problem. Yeah. بيقول لك yeah, quantify it for me. إذا تقول له مثلا والله مال 2000 ريال، يقول لك عندنا 100,000 مشكلة، هذا أنا فاضي لك على 1000 ريال جاي لي تحل المشكلة. لكن لما تقول له اسم مليون ريال، what's he gonna be doing? He's gonna jump from his chair. Yeah, let's fix it right now. So, the first thing, whether it's a problem or it's an opportunity, you need to define it clearly and you need to quantify it. Only then the management will say that, yes, the problem is clear, and yes, I need to take an action against it. Because it was a small amount, عندنا مشاكل كثيرة، 100,000 مشكلة هذا. But if it's a big one, no, I need to focus on it. واضحة؟ That's stage number one. Stage number two is current situation analysis. اللي هو علشان أنا أحل المشكلة، شنو أسباب المشكلة؟ ليش قاعد يصير؟ مرة ثانية نأخذ example مال الشوارع. ليش في تأخير؟ ليش 3 ساعات؟ Why is this congestion? You need to find the details on why is this problem is happening. Sorry? كيف؟ Don't jump the gun. Fine, prove it to me. That's what I'm telling you. Hina, you need to prove it to me. Why is this problem is there? Oh, for the company, there is a losses. Why this losses is there? Yeah, شنو السبب؟ ما كان السنة الماضية، هذه السنة شنو اللي تغير؟ شنو اللي صار؟ You cannot take an action if you do not know what is the problem. Now, how do you get this information? كيف تعرف هذه المشاكل؟ You need to basically start looking at what is available with you. What is available with you? عندكم any reports in the bank or in the company or in Oman? Yeah. If we have, fair enough. If we don't have, is there any reports in the country? That will help me. If there is no report, fine. Who knows? فلنفرض الشخص يعرف هذا، الشخص يعرف هذا. Let me go and talk with him. مثلا عندنا في البنك، if it's خسائر، أنا أروح أول شيء منه، أروح حق الفاينانس تيم. يا جماعة الخير، ليش؟ Show me the trend. كم كان البروفيت مالك على 3 سنوات الماضية، والحين كيف قاعد ينزل، وين نزل؟ Break it down to me. Don't give me. I know you can give me افتراضا the whole thing, but then break it down to me for per individual. وين المشاكل اللي بدأت تصير؟ Report in that kind of perspective. Now, هذا في البنك. لكن فلنفرض لو كنا احنا قاعد نشتغل في شركة بركة أو مزون أو هذول مال الحليب وهذا، وعندنا افتراض المشكلة في الحليب وهذا. Where do I need to go and get the information from? My sales department? Yes, but also my customers. Yeah. And how do I get information from my customers? Sales department, هذول في reports وهذول موجودات. لكن هذول how can I get them? How can I get information from customers, from others? Exactly. Surveys. Yeah? You need to go and find surveys. منو هذولي؟ منو يشتري؟ من عندي؟ مزون. من يشتري أكثر شيء؟ الحليب. رجال ولا نساء؟ وأنا عندي لما كنت أشتغل كانت زوجتي أعطيها، هذا هي تروح تسوي الجروسري كله مال البيت. Then, فأينو. What age? وليش بدوا يغيرون؟ هل في competitors غير مالوتي؟ هل النكهة ما عجبتهم؟ هل هذا؟ I need to understand from them. Yeah, through surveys or through whatever information I can capture from them. Yeah. Now, surveys is very critical. كم واحد يجي لنا survey مرة طول تقريبا ولا 20 صفحة، هذا حد يجاوب عليه؟ We don't give a damn about it. مسحه. هذا. For exactly. For surveys, هنا have to It's an art. Try to know what information do you want and try to get it in a very simple way, if you can. Yeah? That's a way you can capture all this information. And again, I'm going to be talking about kind of it. Once you define all these problems, الحين انت عندك المشكلة رقم واحد وحددنا هذا وعرفنا شنو الأسباب المشكلة. الحين next stage is for you is to go and find what possible solutions there are there. اللي هو يسمونه benchmarking. Now benchmarking في شيئين. Benchmarking انتو تعرفون انه I benchmark between افترض منو أحسن عمان تل ولا أريده. رقم واحد رقم اثنين رقم ثلاثة. That's a benchmarking. Benchmarking another methodology is that let me go and find out from them what have they done. مرة ثانية لما سابقا كنا نشتري الأسهم شنو تروح الشركة الوساطة وتعبي فورم طولة وباغي هذا ويجي لك الحين شنو أنت جالس في البيت doesn't take, I bought assumes it didn't take me more than 2 minutes. Everything is in the application. Yeah. So simple. I go and find that who else had this kind of a problem? Who else was able to fix this problem? How did they fix it? Our ex-deputy director, Dr. Abdul Lamki في PDO, كان يقول احنا في عمان عندنا diarrhea of data collection. Diarrhea يعني عندنا إسهال. يا أحبنا للdata collection. بالهبل نجمع data collection. The problem is, how do I translate this data into a meaningful, what does it mean for me to implement a solution for it? What you need to do is understand what is the problem? It comes back to what is the problem? What are the root causes of the problem? Once you collect the data, theoretically, data should basically itself should it sorts itself out. يعني فلنفرض عندك انت something you went and investigated and you find there is an issue related with the procedures. There is an issue related with HR, with the people. There's issue related with finance. There is issue related with the tools. Now you can see, just جمعيهم كلهم مع بعض. You can see everything related to procedure becomes a procedure. Everything becomes to tools becomes a tools. Everything becomes basically finance becomes a finance kind of it. And thus I will show you later on how to use the Fishbone methodology to give you in that kind of perspective. Data, every data you should collect automatically, it should basically bring itself up to yourself kind of it, yeah? Now, the thing is, after that, for me, the biggest challenge here we have in Oman, عندنا هذا الداتا, كيف أعرف الحلول? Yeah, implement, I'll come into that kind of thing, yeah? Sorry? مركز الإحصاء عنده so many data, yeah, exactly. But how do I translate it into a solutions, yeah? Okay, so that's what's benchmarking. Benchmarking means that I go and learn from others. Wish so. And I, you'll hear this thing into شباب, steal it shamelessly. باخذ من عندهم. خلاص. أتعلم من عندك أخذوا هذا. And I implement it here. Once I, in two, I have the problem. In three, I know what is possible solution. Now in four, I bring the two together. هذا المشكلة وهذا الحلول أنا شفته برا محطوطة. خليني let me go and implement them. Now هنا the trick comes in no, ما كل الحلول تقدرون أنت تحطونها. Why? Because the company strategy, the bank strategy, the country strategy is very, very different. I think a مثال عن مشكلتين هذا سياحة في عمان خريف وصلالة وهذا الحمد لله الحين هالسنة شوية أحسن هذا خريف وصلالة وعمان ما عندنا وهذا وشنو سوينا سابقا مثل مؤتمر قلنا شنو الحلول عشان نجيب ناس هنا. قالوا والله واحدة من الأفكار خلينا نسوي big monument مثل Eiffel Tower عشان الناس يجون هنا في عمان. وش رأيكم good or bad Sorry? Bad. Why? Not attractive. Okay.
Must have a big gymnasium.
طيب.
Also, the culture in Oman are the buildings are supposed to be low.
Okay. Buildings supposed to be low. Guys, I said that. What is the problem? شنو مشكلتنا في عمان في صلالة؟ ما عندنا infrastructure. حمامات ما عندنا. Let's be honest. صح ولا لا؟ يروحون دربات وهذا. But this is the biggest problem. وش دخل Eiffel Towers وهذا الأشياء؟ الحين لما حليناها طلعت مشكلة الشوارع عندنا ضيقة. Yeah. Again, understand what is the problem, guys. Yeah. طيب. نفتح سياحة ما مشكلة ما نبي Eiffel Tower خلنا نسوي مثل دبي. Can we do that? No. Culturally, we are totally different. We cannot have the concept of Dubai. We cannot have the concept of Thailand. We cannot have the concept of other countries in Oman. We are, as a society, different. So when you're bringing solutions, you need to say that whether these solutions work for you or not. If it's in a bank, is it in line with my strategy? If it's the country, is in line with my strategy as a country. انتوا بعدكم شباب شايفين في محطات البترول عندنا مثل سلكت وهذولي صح؟ سابقا ما كان في بس محطة بترول محطة بترول تشوفون في الافلام الامريكية القديمة هذا في بداية الفين في 95 بدأت الفكرة انه guys why don't we نبدأ نسوي هذا الشيء there was so much resistance وانا كنت شغال في فيديو مع شل انه شل يقول يا اخي احنا شركة نفط وش دخلنا بالاسواق والهذا It is not in my line with my strategy. We changed the strategy. One of the solutions, we changed the strategy. You know, let's be honest. To extend, you know, تعرفون بعض الأماكن اللي كانت petrol stations طلع إن الناس ما يبغوا petrol stations فيهم يريدون محلات. For we had in some places in Europe, they basically demolished the petrol station بس خلوا محلات or motels. Yeah, totally different in terms of strategy. And itself, kind of it, yeah? So, once you have in two your problems, in three possible solutions, in four, you marry the two together. لهذا المشكلة, هذا هو الحل اللي عندي أنا, it's going to cost me X amount of dollars, it's going to cost me X amount of time, it's going to cost me X amount of resources, whatever. This is my proposed solution. And you present it to your management. And in five, you say that this is a project, I will go and implement it. Yeah, so these are the five stages that you need to go through any problem that you're going to see or any initiatives that you're going to see. And I'll go with the details with a little bit of them. Is it clear what I'm saying? Yeah? Boring or exciting? Okay, so as I said, the first one is a problem definition. The first thing is that The definition must be as clearly and as precise as possible. مثل ما قلنا. Congestion on Oman roads, very wide. Be specific. Is it congestion or basically on which road and on which time? Yeah? ما تقدرون تحلون كل المشاكل. Focus on your issue, yeah, and you will be able to. هنا, define the problem as a problem only. Define the opportunity as an opportunity only. Don't bring any solutions. Example, the problem. Starting a promotion campaign to increase sale. In mushkila shinu, sales is declining. So the problem, so what should say, decline in sales. Wish to have promotion. يمكن ما يحتاج promotion. يمكن يحتاج totally something different. Don't mix things together. Yeah? So, When you're defining a problem and repeating, define it as clearly as possible, as crystal as possible. The current situation analysis, and we talked about it, you need to understand what is the root causes of the problem. You will not be able to come up with any solutions if you keep jumping the guns. حتى مع خبرتكم, حتى مع بعد 5 سنوات, حتى بعد 10 سنوات, I know it will help you, but don't jump the gun. And I've given a number of examples here. Yeah, be very specific. Go and understand what is the problem. Not by, and you need to basically substantiate it with data. شنو هي المشكلة؟ شنو حجم المشكلة؟ بكرة المدير مالي يقول لك على أي أساس أنت تقول لي هذا هو المشكلة هذا هو؟ Because look at, I have the evidence. I have my daily reports. I have my financial reports. I have my interviews that I've done with people. Yeah, I have my interview that I've done with the strategy. Yeah, I have all the proof that yes, this is the problem. Yeah, so research to find out the problem and the size of the problem. When you're talking about a problem, when you're going and presenting to your management, إذا قلت لهم هذه المشكلة عندي وشنو كم تأثر على الشركة كم تأثر على البنك والله هذا يكلفني تقريبا قاعد نخسر على $2,000 بالسنة فاضي لك أنا على $2,000 you need to be substantiated yeah okay different kind of تكلمنا عن reports وال sources of data yeah لكن don't stick to one type of source of data. It have to be multiple sources of data. Another thing you need when you're capturing the data, it have to be authentic data. لا تروحون على انستغرام وهذا نص المعلومات فيه كل wrong و not right وهذا واليوم الثاني هذا. You need to have substantiated data. Once, وانتو شباب, and that's one thing which I can tell you, is that your first encounter with your management is very critical. It sets your credibility. لما أول مرة عندكم مشروع تروحون تقابلون مدير مالكم هذا, when you tell him نص الكلام كذا وهذا وهذا وهو يسألكم وانتو تلفون وتدورون كذا هذا, what sort of credibility do you think you will have? What do you think he will tell you? ما باين على هذا الشخص my future leader هذا. It's here where you establish your credibility. When you go there, I have a problem. This is the problem. This is the size of the problem. Yeah, I need to move forward with it. If you're able to convince him, هذا. إحنا لما كنا نسوي recruitment في PDO, واحد من الexercises كنا نسويه حق الناس اللي نبي نوظفهم. قلنا لهم تصور أنت وصلت للشركة الصباح, وإحنا عندنا البناية 3 طوابق. نين واقف في المصعد عند عشان تدخل المصعد وفجأة جاء عندك راؤول رستوشي المدير العام. الحين من الطابق الأرضي للطابق الثالث كم وقت بياخذ في الأسانسير؟ دقيقة تقريبا. Okay, and you have a problem. You've got 1 minute. Now convince me that this is the problem. 1 minute. What are you going to be doing? Are you going to give me a long story وتجي تشرح لي وهلا, ولا you have to be basically sharp and to the point. This is the problem. This is what is costing us as a company. Yeah, this is what I'm proposing. Think of it from that perspective. When you're sitting and presenting, you have to be very specific. كلنا نروح السينما. مرات نروح السينما نشوف فيلم boring ومالي خلق وطالع التلفوني 1000 مرة. ومرات أدخل السينما أشوف فيلم من أول لحظة إلى آخر لحظة ما شليت عيني من على الشاشة. Why? It's how exciting that movie is. And that is how exciting you need to be presenting the issue to your management to convince them. A, to convince them. B, this will build into your credibility. Once you do that the first time, you're going to be branded as what we call it, the golden boy and the golden girl of this organization. بعدين حتى لو سويتوا خطأ لا مخالف مش الحال. بنمشيها عشان ما because they are so good يعني I can tell you from experience that's what's going to be happening yeah so senior management must be convinced of this problem when you're presenting it yeah the and it have to be in line with my strategy I cannot go and present إلى افتراضا سليمان الحارثي هنا هو CEO of Oman Arab Bank with a opportunity which is not related to the banking sector. مالي دعواني في هذا الشيء. It has to be in line with my strategy. It has to be in line. I cannot go and propose للحكومة حلول عن سياحة something which is not right within our community in Oman. Yeah, it has to be in line in that kind of perspective. Once you define your problem, then it is the normal project management. You define who is your people, your resources, what action do you want to take, and what time each action is going to be doing. And you put in can't charge for it. We talked about going and gathering the data. You cannot basically decide in terms of what is the problem until you know what is the information, what is the exactly the root causes of the problem. Go and get them from reports. Go and get them from, we talked about, go and get them from an interviews. Go and get them from surveys. Go and get them from searching around the world in that kind of a perspective. But what you need to do is you need to basically get them into the right format. Get all the information, put them together. And the problems would then show themselves up for you. The way to present problems, شايفين هذا يمكن في الجامعة وهذا شو قلكم fish one من شايف fish one scenarios ولا لا show of hand من شايف fish one sorry yeah yeah هذا fish one you start basically مع الhead high operation cost هذا هو المشكلة مالتنا صح. And then you capture all the data that it came up with, you start putting them on the table, and then you start grabbing them together, whichever basically makes sense. So you can see that materials, methods, environment, measurement, machines, workers, all of them, they basically come together. You don't need to do anything here, theoretically. The data should do it for itself. When you capture all the data, when you put them on the table, واحد من الداتا بيجون مع بعض. You just need to basically put them together, select them, put them rightly. Is it making sense? You've done through this through this, yeah. So you capture all the data. Once you capture it, هنا عندنا 6 buckets, yeah. هل عشان نحل المشكلة لازم we address all the 4 of them? Oh, sorry, all the 6 of them? Not necessarily. It might be one of them which will fix 60% or 70% or 30% or 40% of the problem. What you need is to find out which one of them has the highest priority for you. And the way to do it, سمع عن Pareto analysis. Pareto analysis, another word, is 80-20. 80% من مشاكل العالم لها حلول. بس ما نعرف احنا وينها. What you need is to go and search for them. But that's what Pareto analysis tells you. So هنا, we from the previous one, how the 6th one, we find out what is the root causes of it and came up with. And we said that this is basically the loading of them. معناته if we mistakes in production, if it was resolved, 60% من مشاكلنا راح تنحل. واضحة؟ Once you know what is your actual problems, then it's time to go and find solutions for it. Now, solutions, when you go for it, go and start thinking out of the box. I'll take a مثال. Competency HR, واحدة من شركات leading training companies in Oman. But in addition to training, they do a lot of what we call it headhunting. وجزء كبير من ال CEOs وال director generals وال مدراء العموم في الشركات الكبيرة have been placed by competency HR. مرة ثانية أنتم بعدكم شباب بعد أيام سابقا كان بريد عمان من يذكر بريد عمان قبل ما تصير الحين سابقا كانت لمن لسه في إيد الحكومة كانت حكومية كانت miserable performance يعني بعدين حولوها إلى الشركة. واحدة من الأشخاص اللي حطوهم عبد الملك اللي هو الحين هو director general في أسياد became the CEO of بريد عمان. One of the things which he wanted to change was is he said that I would like to improve customer satisfaction. Yeah? So, طلب من competency HR, go and help them to do benchmarking مع شركات ثانية on competence, on customer satisfaction. الشركة شنو؟ بريد عمان. المطلوب benchmarking على customer satisfaction. So, who should we benchmark with? Who should we benchmark with? Sorry? DHL. ليش؟ عشان شركة نفس التوصيل وهذا. رحت DHL ماله مني هذا؟ من رايح DHL هذا محله مني هذا الويرهاوس ماله؟ سوق سمك. Do you think that is a good هذا؟ سمعت أنا شنو قلت؟ قلت customer satisfaction. أول شيء شنو قلت؟ افهموا exactly what they need. He is not talking about improving the توصيل البريد. He would like to improve customer satisfaction. Okay, so who should we benchmark with? Come on, people. Sorry? Customers. Which customers? I would like to benchmark with another company. So who should I benchmark with? I am Bareed Oman. I would like to do benchmarking on customer satisfaction. Who should I benchmark with? Talk to me. Bunuk? Huh? Sorry? McDonald's. مرات انا اروح الطابور الله هداك هذا وهذا غيره منه بنك مسقط رحت بنك مسقط اكيد عندك مليون ريال لان اذا عندك مليون ريال تروح بنك مسقط يعاملونك زين اذا ما عندك مليون ريال هذا بيسكونك هذا بالطابور مالهم اللي بنها تطلع روحك هذا صح ولا لا سوري عمان تل you're satisfied with عمان تل's customer performance Who do you think is the best in terms of customer satisfaction? Okay, I can tell you. قرروا ينسوون مع الهوسبيتاليتي. لو تشوفون حتى a three-star hotel, حتى two-star hotel, the reception they receive the الناس عندهم in a much better way than Oman Tel, than McDonald's, than DHL, than others. Kind of it. That's what they do. Fine? طلع انه قال ويل دو ات بيسيكلي مع ريتز كارلتون اللي يديرون البستان بالضبط انزين طلع صديقه اتصل فيه باغي هذا ان شاء الله ولا يهمك تومورو فور بيبل كام ان تو بريد عمان فور 4 ويكس ذا ثينج هاز امبروفد وين يو دوينج بنشماركينج You need to first define what is the problem that you're trying to fix. احنا لما سوينا root cause analysis واجد مشاكل خذوا واحدة واحدة. What is the best place for me to go and search for that solution for that problem? إذا أنا عندي مشكلة في customer satisfaction وعندي في procedure, I will not go to the same company I do benchmark with. هذا customer satisfaction, who is the best in terms of customer satisfaction? وهذا procedure, who is the best in terms of survey procedures? Kind of it. Yeah? So when you know the problem, find out who is the best for you to go and find from them. Who can do work for, who can give you a good solution? Another thing which I can, another point, ladies and gentlemen, take it, is the networking. أنا أعطي كورس في مثل هذا في OQ وقل لهم تعرفون your counterparts في PDO؟ تعرفون your counterparts في BP؟ تعرفون your counterparts في Oxy؟ ما أعرف إذا أنتم تشتغلون هنا. Do you know your counterparts in other banks؟ يعني بكرة عندكم مشكلة. فلنفرض في وتبون في بنك ثاني تبون تشوفون الحل هذا تعرفون من هو تقول yeah no guys start building your networks because you can resolve a lot of your problems هنا احنا عندنا في القطاع الخاص لما نبي نسوي سيرفي لما نبي نبعث رساله CEO يقرر بعد نص ساعه هذا انا لما كنت في وزاره الماليه واحدة من الأشياء اللي كنا نبيها نشوفها بشوف حلول، قلت له يا أخي أهل مكة أدرى بشعابها، خلونا نسأل أبعث رسالة لكل موظفي وزارة المالية عشان يعطونا أفكارهم. هذا 6 أشهر اللي من رسالة تطلع من معالي درويش. الحين CEOs يعرفون بعضهم، حتى ما يتصلون على الواتساب. I want this. Give me information of that one. Once you know the person, you'll be able to fix it. That's another thing for you. Start building up. When you start looking into projects, you start building your team. You also need to understand who is the potential people in other organizations that could help you for it. Yeah? اليوم you scratch my back, I scratch your back. Yeah? Okay. So, benchmarking. But please focus in terms of don't go and start benchmarking with something which is out of our norm. You cannot do that because it will not, the solutions will not be implementable for yourself. مثل ما قلنا بالنسبة للسياحة، ما تقدر تجيب السياحة اللي في دبي أو في تايلند تجيبها في عمان. هذا إحنا كدولة غير، إحنا environment مالنا غير. In that perspective, yeah. Focus in terms of what is the best in class. عندكم 4-5 root cause analysis. Not necessarily that you will go for the same company. No, find out for each of these problems who is the best person who can fix this problem for me, yeah, and go and search for it. And please open your horizon. إذا أنا بريد عمان ما شرط I have to stick to DHL or do British Post or هذا. No, find out what do I want and who is the best to provide it for myself. Is it clear? Yeah? Once I have my problems and my possible solutions, now it's for me to basically bring them together and find out whether these possible solutions are implementable or not implementable, and should I basically present them to management or I should not present them to management. وهنا يجي a requirement of is it in line with my strategy? Is it in line with my guideline that's been set? Is it in line with the red line that's been set? One of the examples, أحد من الشركات was suffering. It's a company which does like mayonnaise و ketchup وهذه الأشياء. قال المانجمنت قال لهم go and find a solution because the sales was going downward. And find a solution, go fix it on the following basis. لا عندي فلوس ولا عندي ناس أعطيكم. ماشي فلوس زيادة. Don't ask for any additional money and don't ask for any additional resources. I'm already losing money. For that is a red line. So when you're coming up with the solutions, you need to be very clever in terms of how can you implement these solutions. And finally, it is actually once you present to the management that, Mr. CEO, these are the issues, these are the possible solutions I'm putting it here, yeah, I would like to move forward. He will decide yes or no. And once he decides that kind of thing, you're going to go and start implementing each and every one of those projects, each and every one of those ones. And for that one, you need to define number of things in it. These are identify who is responsible for that work. من اللي بيسوي؟ فلنفرض كانت British Airways. Yeah? Who's going to be purchasing the olives? Yeah? Yeah? Or فلنفرض كانت in any other kind of organization. Who's going to be doing this kind of work? How much money do I need for it? How many additional resources do I need for it? How long is it going to be taking me to do this project? how I'm going to be measuring the success of this project. Yeah, so identify who's responsible, the timeline, the prerequisites, yeah, key performance indicators. How I'm going to be measuring in the, inshallah, how that works, but I need to know whether it's going to work or not work. And how I'm going to be measuring that it's going to be working, through surveys, through increase of profitability, through increase reduction in terms of my losses. Yeah, I need to be defining that kind of thing. Yeah, and any additional resources requires, and the budget that you're going to be requiring for it. Okay. That's in a nutshell, basically, what is a project management? Let's talk about. Yeah? So, what do we said here? Guys, a project is either fixing a problem or it's a capitalizing on an opportunity. A problem might be right now or might be coming in the future. Or it's capitalizing on an opportunity. You have to be crystal clear in terms of what is this problem. Don't keep it open. Yeah? Try to focus your issue. كل الشوارع في عمان إذا نتكلم عن congestion ولا فقط شارع واحد. كل الأوقات ولا فقط أوقات محددة. The second thing is that management will not going to be دائما نقول هذا. تذكرون مايك تايسون كان ملاكم كان عنده مدير أعمال واحد دون كين شعره كذا طويل. هذا مرة يقول لي I will not wake up from my bed for less than $50 million هذا investment. Less than 50 million. نفس الشيء management. Management is driven by it's the profit of the organization. Yeah. إذا تقول له أنا عندي مشكلة صغيرة. كلنا عندنا مشاكل صغيرة هذا. You deal with it. I'm not going to be dealing with that. But if one is going to be saying that, no, it's a big problem and it's around 10 million or 1 million or whatever, whew, he's going to be having. So define the problem very clearly. Define the size of the problem to be able to get the credibility from the management side of it. Yeah? We talked about gathering the data. You cannot basically, والله أنا رأيي كذا, والله أنا أشوف كذا. No, everything has to be substantiated from a financial perspective, from an issue perspective, from a problem perspective. If you have the data, can it be? If you don't have the data, go and find the data through interviews, through focus groups, through surveys, through whatever, and not from one source, from multiple sources. Yeah, and from credible sources. ما يقول لي والله أنا حصلت هذه الداتا بهذا الستاتستكس من وين حصلتها من إنستغرام. منو حاطها الإنستغرام والله ما أعرف. What sort of credibility is going to be there? Yeah. Once we know the problems and you know the weighting of the problem in itself kind of it, then you need into the benchmarking side of it. And again, benchmarking not mean that I benchmark all my problems with one organization. No, you benchmark each and every of your root cause analysis with who is the best to serve you. And here, please, think out of the box. Think out of the box. Yeah, don't restrict yourself to إذا أنا في البنكينج بتكلم بس في البنكينج, إذا أنا في الأويل أند غاز بس بتكلم في الأويل أند غاز. No, open it. But you need to always keep at the back of your head, what is the strategy of my organization? Or what is the strategy of my country? And once I know it, basically, I come up with and proposed solutions for myself. And I present to the management for it. I went very quickly. I was hoping that probably we'll have more interaction in with you kind of it. But now I'm opening the floor for any kind of questions or anything you have. I'm more than happy to answer you for it. Whether being on project management or being on a general, I'm quite old. I'm 56 years old, so I have a lot of, well, to some extent, I have experience. I'm like your father. So if you have any kind of issues or anything, I'm more than happy to answer you in it.
في بعض المشاريع اللي صارت المشاريع المشاريع اللي صارت والمشاكل اللي صارت في زمن كورونا الفترة كان بزنس مان زين عندي مشروع لما صارت الأزمة المالية ما كان عندي الحل كيف أحل هذا الموضوع مثل ما تكلم الحين في هذه المحاضرة يعني استشفينا كيف أنت تقدر تتغلب على المشاكل هذه وتبحث وين بالضبط تكون المشكلة عشان أنت تركز على هالمشكلة وتحلها بكل طريقة بسيطة يعني هذا الحين جميع أعتقد جميع التجار بعضهم واجهوا هذه المشكلة ما كان يحصلوا الجواب الصريح في هذا الشيء أو الحل في هذا الشيء.
بالنسبة اللي حصل بعد كورونا وهذا this was once in a million years. When did we have last time such a huge catastrophe that the whole world has faced in it kind of it. هنا what it says in any project or in any investment you're going to start. عندك مثال فلنفرض الحين OQGN هذا البنوك تعطيك على 1 to 1 صح؟ عندك 1000 ريال يعطونك 1000 ريال زيادة kind of it. Yeah. Now here you need to find out the risk. كم بينزل سعر لمن ينزلون في الاكتتاب والحين 126 بيسة بينزل على كم؟ يقولون 150 إلى 160 ولو منزل على 100 بتكون خسران مثل ما صار مع عمان تل صح؟ هنا what you need is to secure yourself as much as possible وهذا اللي حاصل في العالم كله الحين نشوف صار التضخم في العالم كله في أوروبا وهذا الناس إذا تقرؤون وش يقولون أغلب الناس السيفينجز مالهم is all been eroded One of the reasons why there is so much basically inflation is happening is that people's money was eroded. اللي كنتم خليه للأيام السوداء افتراضا هذا بعد راح من عندي. For investment perspective, it always says that don't use your own cash, مثل ما يقولون. Or at least if you're going to be using your own cash, always keep yourself secured a little bit. It's tomorrow. مثل ما يقول the shit hits the fan yeah you're not going to be drowning at least you're going to be having something protect yourself with a little bit something here and there yeah sure مثل ما في المثل يقول لك لا if you pay peanuts you get monkeys yeah if you would like to basically go in a very aggressive way Yes, the profit might be very high, but the risk of something going wrong is also going to be very high. So, it's you as a person. Are you that risk taker? If you're that risk taker, are you basically protecting yourself? If you're not protecting yourself, who's going to protect you? Yeah. Any more questions? Anything?
أنت قلت إنه نغير استراتيجية إذا it doesn't align يعني لازم يكون the solution aligns with the strategy متى نعرف إنه متى نغير استراتيجية؟
Strategy is changed by the management by the shareholders. Strategy you don't change it because of a simple solution. It's a strategy. Manage banks. Yeah. What are the strategy of banks? is always basically the same kind of thing. Yeah? شنو الفرق ما بين Islamic banking و normal banking? Normal banking is depending basically on loans and this kind of thing. Islamic banking is saying that, no, I cannot give you cash, I'm going to give you a product. فهنا بدل ما أنا أعطيك فلوس حسنا تروح تشترين سيارة, أنا بشتري لك سيارة. I'm opening something totally different. I'm opening a small branch of selling cars. Yeah? This doesn't happen on us on an issue basis. This happens on the shareholders on هذا. لما أنا وأنت فلنفرض نروح نفتح لنا شركة. We set the target. What is our strategy? We're not going to change it because of here and there. Except if we see that there is a drastic thing is going to be happening in that perspective. مثل شل. مثل ما قلت هذا كان عندهم بس محطات بترول. وما شغلهم مال يفتحون محلات وما شغلهم مال يفتحون موتيلات. وشركة بترول هذه من طلع أويل وغاز ما لها هذا. لكن لما شافوا انه it's a big thing It's a really huge thing. هنا قالوا, no, we will change the strategy from that kind of a perspective.
Thank you, Mahmoud, for this session. I think you have a lot to share that we have not covered today at all. Project management is a deep topic. So I'm just going to focus on what I think everyone in here is thinking, given that most are fresh graduates. I think now we're all in problem-solving mode and trying to think of a problem and trying to find a solution. It's not like that. Sometimes you could either notice it, and some things just take time. So for example, with the strategy, with my experience, it took me 1 year to be able to identify what the problem is, till I settled down, till I caught up, till I understood the business, till I understood how to read different kind of reports. It takes time. Don't just rush into work. What I want to say, and I don't think that we should be rushing into work, trying to see where the problem is. Or sometimes, maybe because we're fresh graduates, we tend to identify things that others are already aware of. And this is not to just downgrade our idea or underestimate, but most likely, maybe just start by thinking what has been done about this before.
Now, let me tell you one thing. سمعت عن لين لا. Lean Six Sigma, yeah? شنو الفرق ما بين Lean Six Sigma و Problem Solving هنا? Lean Six Sigma معناته removing the waste. البروسس صح, ما عندنا مشكلة. Things are moving, مثل أنا جاي الحين أفتح حساب, بجي أروح عند الموظفة, أعبي فورمات, والموظفة بعدين تحطه في الكمبيوتر, وبعدين هذا, فمعناته البروسس هذه, it will go through two or three people, and it will take for 7-8 hours. Do we need to change the process? Do we need to eliminate the process? Is the process wrong? No, I need it. After حساب, after حساب. The problem with lean, what lean does is that is يحتاج موظفين, يحتاج 6 hours, ولا لا أنا أقدر أسوي أسرع. For lean is removing the waste. Or here sometimes when you're as a young graduate, when you see something, you need to identify whether it is actually I need to remove the waste or there is totally something wrong going on. Make that thing very clear for yourself. Yeah, removing the waste. من منكم يتذكر تذكرون ملكيات الأراضي سابقا اللي كانت لونها gray كانت بالأسامي, يمكن ما تذكرون بعضكم شباب أنتوا هذا. سابقا الملكية الأرض لما كنا واحد يروح يشتري أرض, the time until it gets issued is 1 month. 1 month أنا دافع شاري ودافع فلوسي وهذا عشان أحصل ملكية, it will take me 1 month. Now you go in the afternoon, next day at 9 o'clock it will be issued for you. Wow. نفس الملكية. Nothing has changed. What has changed? It has changed the process. So much waste in it. Yeah? That was how the kind of it. For differentiate between a true problem and whether it's basically an improving of the problem. That's one thing. The second thing, guys, my advice to you at this age, try to understand how things are working. Don't مرة ثانية حتى أنتوا مرات لمن شباب هذا وأنا تعلمت هذا الشيء وبعدين شفت لا هذا شيء ما عادل هذا. You do not know until you understand it. في بعض الأشياء you might think it is طول وهذا وهذا, بس because of other reasons which you do not have the experience about it. Kind of it. فunderstand as much as possible the processes, the way things are working. Later on you could basically focus on it.
Thank you. But let's just focus on one thing. What about change management? Yani when you're solving a problem, how much change are you going to do? And you're not the only one who's going to need to cope with that. In fact, you may be in the spotlight of needing to cope with that and needing to get people on board with you. Just how to manage that from your experience, if you could share an example, if any.
Change management is... People always love to live in their comfort zone. Yeah, أنا متعود على هذا الشيء ما بيش أغيره هذا. Yeah, people always live it like that kind of it. Very few people who are الناس اللي يعجبهم لا أنا ما يعجب status quo مثل ما يقولون هذا. I'm one of them. أنا كنت أغير شغلي ما بين كل سنتين تقريبا. ليش؟ I was getting bored. Whenever I feel like I'm stable, I'm looking for a new challenge. Yeah. Now most of the people, they don't like any kind of challenges. Yeah. Change management is understanding how do I manage the fears of the people and how can I basically make the change happening. That's what I can tell you from people's perspective, not from a systems perspective. It's total kind of thing. But change management, this thing, is how can I understand what are the fear of the people? ليش خايفين؟ ليش غير؟ احنا شوية مرات النيو آي أو إس ينزل وهذا هو تعال هذا تغير وهذا هذا صار كذا وهذا الآيكون صار فوق وهذا صار تحت هذا kind of it. We straight forward start talking about it kind of it, yeah? Because we don't feel the comfortable. We like things as it was. And that's a normal human being's behavior, kind of it. But it's how do you convince them, and how can you set the methodology and the correct way of handling this change to convince them that this change needs to be happening and implement this change? Yeah? Anyone more questions? Anything? Any clarity? Any other kind of issue other than probably project management?
Be mind that no one's asking questions. I have many. Project management is it can be as a whole تخصص. It can be a whole major. People study it. People and people don't, and they still get into it. What would be the? Let's narrow it down to three key points that, from your experience, you'd like to pass on to us regarding project management in our careers, if that makes sense.
I think I've mentioned some of them. As a project manager, just like a manager, just like a team leader, just like a CEO, lower down your ego. انتو كل ما تشتغلون كل ما تصير عندكم خبرة كل ما ما أدري إذا أنا ما عندي جراف هنا بس يقولك في البداية الناس لما يبدون يشتغلون وشوية بعد سنة تصير عندهم خبرة وخاصة من الشطار هذا على طول they think themselves أنا فوق وبدون حتى they start حتى they criticizing CEOs وهذا ليش ما يسوون كذا وهذا ليش ما يسوون كذا هذا lower down your ego. ما you are smart but everybody is smart as well. Yeah, use what does that mean? Means that listen to the people, and that's what I said. Jack Welch, the اللي يسمونه manager of the century. اللي حول جي اي من شركه خسرانه الى كانت لفتره قبل ما يقارب من 15 سنه اكبر شركه في العالم. قال انا ما اسوي شيء. I'm just inviting people like I'm making a feast. Everybody come and talk. He's not telling them what to do, whatever. He's just telling them talk between themselves. They know they are smart. They know they can have it. He's utilizing the power of the people in itself. Kind of it. That's one thing. You need to basically be very critical. Yeah? Use the people. A true leader, want to, inshallah, you're going to be the future leaders of this of the business in Oman, kind of it. Yeah? Your capability will be, as a true leader, is how can you take everybody from point one to point two together? Yeah? All of them. ما تتركون حد وراكم. Yeah? Move them in that kind of way. So lower your ego. Listen to everybody. Listen to what people say. Yeah. Don't cut anybody. In a meeting, a true leader is not the person who talks more. He's the person who talks less, actually. لكن شنو يسوي؟ يخلي كل واحد من الشباب البنات يتكلمون. عطوني رأيكم. أنا لما كنت مثل ما قلت أنا I was jumping from يعني I was moving from every 2 to 4 years to another job. The first thing I used to go and sit with the people and say, guys, what is your problem? انت عندك فريق, عندك تيم, عندك مشاريع, عندك هذا. شنو المشاكل اللي تواجهها? How can I help you? لما كنا نروح لين, بعد ما نخلص اللين, كنا نسوي شيء يسمونه سمعته عن جامبا ووك. جامبا ووك, هذا راوني كيف حلوت المشكلة وهذا. As a management, بس كنا نسمع. وبعد آخر شيء نقول لهم شيء واحد. How can I help you? أنا كنت أقول حق my staff people, you don't work for me, I work for you. Tell me, what do you want me to do? Because I am a manager, I have more power. You're not able to basically break the wall. I will break the wall for you. Yeah, lower your ego. Use the people that you have. Yeah, listen to them, help them in that kind of perspective for yourself. Yeah, and I mentioned a number of things as well. Networking, guys. Networking, networking, networking. وحدكم ما بتحلون أي مشكلة. الفريق مالكم ما بيحل أي مشكلة. لكن إذا تعرفون منه موجود في هذه الشركة ومنه موجود في هذه الشركة ومنه موجود في هذه الشركة. الحين عند كل على الواتساب هذا عندنا هذه المشكلة كيف الحل بيعطونك إياه. ممكن تساعدنا أي حاضرين.
Did you like puzzles when you were younger?
Did I like puzzles?
Yes, because you're a project manager, right?
Yeah.
And I feel like project management is solving issues. So did you like puzzles when you were younger?
No, I didn't actually. Well, yeah, I mean, I'm not going to be puzzled. But there wasn't much of a puzzle to هذه الأشياء. يعني أنا أذكر أول مرة شفت الكمبيوتر أنا وأنا في الجامعة. وبعد ما كان بي سي وهذا كان سن ورك ستيشن هيوج ون يا بس الفيرست ما كان سي سو كان ايماجن يعني لابتوبس وي هاف سين ات لابتوب سين ات افتر ستارت هلا والله حتى ما بديت مع بي دي او يعني لابتوبس اف سين ات ان ترولي يعني اف سين ات ان ذا كمباني وات ايفر سنه قريب ال 2000 نهايه ال 1998 99 شفنا بدنا شفنا اللابتوبس وهذه الاشياء ما كان في هذا الأشياء. Total tough life you can say a little bit but that's it. الحين ما شاء الله كل واحد على ال على الواتساب وهذا وأنا عيالي حتى يدرسون لما كانوا يدرسون وهذا أنا أتذكر أيامينا كان هذا تروح نوقف على البوث مال التلفون هذا ننتظر خط لي من هذا عشان اتصل في أبوي في أمي أقول لهم كيف حالكم وهذا. Any more questions?
I'm curious to know.
Sure.
What was your major? What was your major?
My major?
Yes, like what you studied.
I did an IT. I'm an IT graduate, an electronic system engineering. And I joined BDO, and I worked for 12 years in the IT. But then my mind was more at the initiated, started as in the IT, the projects there, kind of it. And then I became a strategist. For the IT, putting the strategies in terms of moving forward, and they said that fine, he has a good brain in terms of financing or whatever. So they've moved me to finance, kind of it. So right now, my expertise, if I say that, if I'm good at, I'm good in terms of contracting, and contracting and legal. كل العقود and what does it mean وهذا وحتى to the extent إحنا نعرف فرق ما بين is وذا في sentence شنو ممكن تغير معنى الجملة يعني هذا. In terms of liability and responsibility of having in terms of projects, kind of it. So yeah. Anything else? Please.
نعم اتكلمت عن الاستراتيجي والبروجكت لازم يكون فيه يعني align with the strategy ولكن بعض الاحيان يكون في mandate من برا يعني مثل CBO Central Bank of Oman لازم تطبقوا هالشيء مثلا بخصوص Apple Pay فits out of the bank strategy sometimes خلينا نقول اذا كان technical if كان engineering problem يأثر على production فits not based on strategy sometimes projects comes from different يعني non strategic projects فهذه بس نقطة
mandates are part of the strategy and even higher of the strategy we are all operating in Oman فأول قانون اللي مفروض يطبق وين سواء كان في شركة النفط والغاز سواء كان في البنوك سواء كان في construction companies what is the Omani law احنا عندنا في فيديو العقود عندنا هذا عقد افتراضا وهذا المطلوب من عندنا نسويه. طيب لكن هذا اذا كان في تعارض ما بينه وما بين قانون العمل العماني نو قانون العمل العماني takes over the precedence. هنا البنوك البنك عندك استراتيجيه ماله عنده هذا، لكن اذا كان في تعارض ما بينه وما بين السي بي او هو takes over سي بي او because they are the governing body. والاستراتيجيه مال البنك تقول لك هذا الشيء اذا كان في تعارض it should take over.
يعني انا خلال تدريبي مع ال ان جي مثلا we encounter some problems اللي هو مثلا في البرودكشن one of the trains shut down for more than a month. المشكله هي مشكله تكنيكال يعني وشيء اوت اوف يعني روتين، وغير كذا انه مش انه في استراتيجي ولكن اوت اوف ذس بروبلم صار في سكوب صار في تايم فريم صار في بادجت كوميتد تو ذات تو سولفينج ذوز بروبلمز. فبعض الحين كوس نان استراتيجيك بروجكتس فيا بهالحالات مثلا
ان شوف ان اني بروجكت يو ار جونا بي انكاونترينج ثينجز ويتش از اوت اوف ذا نورم. انا اعطيك مثال في الاويل اند غاز عندنا، طبعا دائما لما نحفر هذا يطلع لك البترول يطلع لك الغاز، دائما تشوفون احنا تشوفون شعلات لهذا مال هذا. طبعا هذا والحين عندنا زيرو كاربون ايميشنينج الاستراتيجي ب 2030 المفروض يكون زيرو. هذا الغاز شويه يطلع سنه بيج ديل، الحكومه تقول نو تعرف هاو ماتش ات واز يوز تو كوست بي دي او والحكومه نفسها تو نوت تو فلير ذا غاز مليونز اند مليونز. يمكن هذا خساره خلي يروح الغاز ما مشكله عندي هذا شويه هذا، لكن واي شود اي بيسيكلي بيك ذا مليونز ان ذات كان. هنا يو نيد تو بيسيكلي بالانس ذا ثينج اوت. يو از ا بروجكت مانجر اولويز جونا بي ذا ثينجز كامينج اوت اوف ذا نورم. And here, basically, you need to negotiate. Find out what is actually the cost of this abnormal or this external. Yeah? How much is it going to cost me? Is that in line with my strategy? Yes or no? Is that going to affect my license to operate? تعرف شو اسمه license to operate? License to operate معناته كل شركة وكل هذا احنا نتبع نظام. ما عندنا في بي دي او وشركات النفط، شركات النفط تقول لك ما مفروض انتم توسخون الانفايرمنت، ما مفروض انتم تقتلون الناس، معنا مع الاسف مع ان شركات النفط تصرف مئات الملايين، لكن كل سنه عندنا تسمعون هذا الشيء، في ناس على الاقل خمسه سته يتوفون في بالسنه هذا. هذا لايسنس تو اوبريت، لا تسوون هذا. ما معناته وي نوت وي تراي از ماتش از بوسبل، في يحصل هذا الشيء، بس وي بروفينج ذات وي ار دوينج، ذيس از لايسنس تو اوبريت، مثل بنوك نو فرود. This is license. If a bank sells a fraud, you know what they fee? Intentionally, they will cut it off. Second one, that's a license to operate. You know, you need no fraud. Yeah. In any project, you're going to be facing this kind. This is a norm, and that's your responsibility. If everything goes مثل ما هذا مخطط له هذا ما يحتاج حتى project manager. نخلي الخطة وخلاص كل واحد يمشي هذا. مثل ما كنت أقول له لما كل يوم كنت أجي الصباح عن الدوام أقول هذا. هل أنا محتاجين للشركة ولا لا؟ If at the end of the day everything went fine, I did not have to intervene with anything, I did not earn my money. Yeah? As a project manager, you're always going to be seeing these kind of things. And here it is basically for you to balance the thing out. You look at it from a cost perspective, you look at it from a reputation perspective, you look at it from a procedure perspective, you look at it basically from a license operator perspective, and make a judgment. Whether it is yes, I need to implement it or I don't need to implement it, kind of it. And here also comes is that who should I, and again coming back to the network, who should I go and discuss with this with? Who should I need to basically convince in that perspective? Yeah, is it me going to the CBO? ولا المشكلة لا والله احنا خلينا نستخدم بنك مسقط ونستخدم بنك صحار انا يقول ثلاثتنا احنا هذا will have much more leverage in that kind of perspective. إذا هم أيضا متأثرين بهذا الشيء. And that is what is the project managers is going to be looking at. So it's a norm that you're going to be getting these things out of the out of the blue. Any more questions? Even general kind of thing?
All right. You talked about obstacles and problems that might face the project, but just from your experience from you managing people, just wanted to know obstacles you faced with workers, like your colleagues, the people, your employees that you had. So obviously, like if there is a problem with an employee, it's not gonna be cost effective to just replace anyone that has a problem with. So just from experience, how to deal with that situation and try to improve.
شوفوا تسمعون دائما the most valuable asset of any organization is the people. Yeah, people is the most valuable asset into it. ودائما احنا كنا عندنا لما كنا نتكلم who is the best person to become an HR? Is HR anybody can do it? In my opinion, no. But I'm asking, can anybody become an HR person? For me, no. You need to have a certain kind of sympathy and understanding of people. ما كل واحد. المهندس ما أعتقد يقدر يصير مثل HR إلا لو كان عنده من داخله هذا الشيء. Yeah, finance person might not be. But a person is who is truly a good person who can understand what is emotions, what is people, how do they feel kind of it. Yeah. But the most important thing, how can I get maximum out of them? انتوا لما يكون عندكم تيم يكون عندكم فريق ولما يكون عندكم مجموعة أعمال, how are you going to be distributing this work to those people? Just like that, randomly? No. You need to understand the strength of each and every person. هذا الشخص شنو زين فيه؟ وهذا الشخص وهذا الأخت شنو زين فيها؟ And what are their capabilities? And based on that one, you give them the work in that perspective. Why is that? A, they will enjoy doing the work. B, they will be really productive because they like it. Yeah. C, the project is going to finish brilliantly because that's going to be happening. Now, as a project manager, it is not only your capabilities from a technical perspective, from a financial perspective. It is your capabilities as a leader. واحنا قلنا is a person who is basically able to take the people from point one to point B. هنا you need to have understand the sympathy. People management is an art. Well, I know you're still young, but this is something which you start need to learn about it. شوفوا كيف تعاونون أصدقائكم صديقاتكم. Yeah, you need to start dealing with your staff like that. I'm ill and I feel really proud when some people come and say to me, some senior people say that, يقولوا لي مدير وهذا, أنا بنتي تشتغل في OQ, واحد من المدراء يقول إلى الآن تقول لي بابا, إلى الآن تقول لي أبوها كان مديري. He feels, I feel proud. But that is what you need to feel, the way you manage your people. When you become a manager, project manager, it's not your technical, it's not your financial capabilities that is important. It's also your ability to understand people and keep that one and develop it right now with yourself, please, as you move on. Yeah? And you need to understand the people. What is the strength when you have a team? What is the strength? What are the capabilities? What are the drawbacks of each person that you're going to be having? And you need to manage them from that kind of a perspective. I've seen a lot of manager which is مثل صراخ وهذا وطلع وهذا, that's not going to be working. That's not, doesn't. في ناس أنا شفتهم, في أحد الأشخاص كان يشتغل عندي, أنا I had a team leader تحته, قال هذا ما زين وهذا هذا, وآخر شيء الرجال ضايق وطلع من بيديو. Guess what, he's a CEO right now of a huge company. A CEO of a huge company in Oman. He was the person underneath me. I tried my best, but the person underneath me was not able to manage him. That's an example. I cannot say the names, يعني, but that is true. So it is an art. And you need, just like being a financial, technical person, you need to basically also develop these kind of skills for yourself. As you move on right now. Sorry?
Sometimes you have to escalate if you have a project and it keeps delaying.
يمكن الشخص التكنيكال او صاحب الفكره يكون متاخر يقدم هالمستندات اللي يحتاجها اساس moving forward with your project. فانت ما توصل مرحله ان you have to escalate يعني.
So you do your best. You see, when you have these kind of situations, sit with the person, talk with him, tell him, how can I help you? يمكن المشكله ما في هو, المشكله في انه he is been hitting with a wall. وانت المانجر المفروض اللي تساعده ما جالس ونايم. مثل ما قلنا, some of the project من يخلصون, we go as a management الى هذا يقول, guys, what can I do for you? Now use me. انتوا سويتوا اللي تقدرون عليه, now use me. Yeah? شنو المشكله؟ What are the problem? What are the issue? Help him in that kind of perspective. If you did all of these things and it's still not working, that's a different matter. Yeah? That's a different matter. Although even that one, مثل ما قلت لك الاكزامبل هذا, it might not be true يعني, but at least you've done whatever you can. But again, it's an art. It's not just a pure science, it's an art. Of dealing with people is an art. Yeah, and you need to have the sympathy and empathy to deal with the people, to understand them, to get the maximum out of them. And when they do, when you do that, believe me, you will do wonders because they will do everything for you. أنا إلى الآن أتذكر سنة 2018 صارت مثل طفرة عندنا في عمان. أنا كان عندي 60 موظف, كان عندي 200 contract worth $17 billion. في خلال 3 أشهر I've lost 20 people. من 60 شخص صاروا 40, 20 شخص استقالوا, حصل better offers in that kind of perspective. Yeah, do you think I was able to manage my business? Yes, I was able to. My team did wonder job. At the end of the that year, I told them, I've never seen a team, honestly, that served me like that. Because we work together. لمن فريق يفقد 30% من الستاف ماله. من 60 سنة صرنا 40. نفس البورتفوليو, نفس لا وبعد الماركت was overheated. فيعني more work kind of it. Yet they were able to deliver. Yeah. So don't think as a manager, inshallah, لما تصيرون managers, is that تأخذون مثل بالعصاية سووا كذا سووا كذا. No, on the contrary, it's an art you need to establish between technical, financial, human things for yourself, and start developing it right now, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, for yourself. Technical stuff, I can tell you, technical stuff, yes, we all can develop, but these are the things which is very critical. Yeah, that no, a lot of people are successful in it.
What are some skills that a high flyer would have? Like in PDO, you guys have high flyers, the ones that you see have potential. What are some skills that we should develop at this age?
For me, I always used to, when people used to, when I used to give work to people, كان يقول لي أستاذ محمود متى تريده؟ أقول له أمس. You work in an environment, you work in a company, لا؟ هذه الشركات كلها فلوس, هذه الفلوس ناس. Yeah? Don't waste my time. Don't, when I'm saying that, don't waste my time, your time, and everybody's time. When we need, you need to understand, appreciate the work, you need to appreciate the time. That إذا إحنا ما سوينا اليوم بنخسر كذا. من بيخسر هذا؟ الناس اللي قاعد يدفعون رواتبنا. Yeah. So that's the first thing you understand, is that it's time management for yourself. Yeah. Manage your time properly, but appreciate basically that the work is needed yesterday, not. Well, what I mean by that is that I know that you're going to be doing it after 1 week, kind of, but you appreciate, you know, what does that mean? Means that every day passes, we're losing money, or every day passes, there is creating a problem that is affecting us in a negative way. Yeah? Appreciate that kind of thing. That's number one. Number two is that, I don't want to say it, but it might be, it's some people have ability to have to do multitasking. But that is not a natural thing. في ناس عندهم, في ناس ما عندهم. I can do 2-3 works basically, 2-3 jobs or 2-3 tasks at the same time. Yeah, I can balance the thing out kind of it. Yeah. But that for me is not a critical. What is critical for me was is that you deliver. You deliver it in the right way. How would you deliver it the right way? إذا أنتم ما كنتم فاهم مين أساساً شنو المشكلة. So ask question. مثل ما قلت لكم يا أما جلسنا في اجتماعات واحد يتكلم وبعد ما نطلع كل واحد يطلع ثاني وش السالفة؟ وش المشكلة؟ ما حد كل واحد مستحي يسأل يقول أوه يقولون عني هذا ثور ما أفهم ولا شيء هذا sorry say that kind of it. But that's it. Don't ask the question. If you don't understand, ask the question. But that's what happened. And I can tell you honestly, in any meeting you go there, half of them ما فاهمين يمكن السالفة شنو لكن كل واحد مستحي ما باغي يقول إنه هذا ما فاهم هذا. Any more questions? ما أنا بعتقد هذا المكان يعني لهذا الأشياء ولا إنه هذا. Anything else? Or shall we call it a day? طيب. Thank you very much. I truly appreciate the opportunity that I've given and wish you all the best, inshallah. And I hope to see you in the future, near future or longer future, basically, as the true leaders of this country, inshallah. And wish you all the best. Barakallahu feekum, wa Allah yahfazkum, inshallah.
مساء الخير جميعا. بس في وجبات برا على المخرج اللي في الخلف. شكرا لكم ولا تنسوا تسوي سكان عشان سيرتيفيكيتس.